Don't speak to me this way. Don't ever let me say. Don't leave me again.
The weather today is 72 degrees, partly sunny, with chances of showers.
Oh, you never felt this lost before, and the world is closing doors. I never wanted anything.
This is WXSC 86.9, playing all of your favorite hits. Right now, we have the newest chart topper by Michael White.
Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both, and be one traveler long I stood, and looked down one as far.
Surprise! Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Brian. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, Brian. Blow out your candles.
Is everything okay, honey? Is it about having children again?
I just don't want to wait any longer, money or not.
We'll make this work, Sarah. I promise.
Money. No. Money. No. Money. No.
Hi, Brian.
Hi, Janet.
Nice day out.
Yes, very.
Bye, Brian.
Bye, Janet. Center for Human Research. Money.
At the Center for Human Research, we perform crucial human testing for the government.
Our latest testing revolves around human census. You will be in the auditory division, headed by Dr. Keats, right over there. As you can see, he's very dedicated to his work. Excuse me, doctor. Doctor! Doctor!
Oh! I'm sorry, Dr. Van Ostrin. I seem to have gotten lost in my work again.
This is becoming somewhat of a habit of yours lately. This is Brian Smith.
Brian! It's very nice to meet you. I think you're going to find the research here very rewarding, and not just because of the pay. You see, we have discovered an amazing, amazing thing here. I think you will soon find yourself just as passionate about this as I am.
Brian, why don't we fill out the necessary paperwork?
Brian. Your job for the next 2 days is to listen to auditory algorithms we will be sending to these headphones. While you conduct your everyday affairs, you must feel, experience, and be cognizant of any changes happening to you. We will be monitoring you from the lab. Good luck, Brian. Hello, Dr. Van Ostrand speaking.
Doctor.
Dr. Keats has been taking off the study due to illness. I am now in charge of the experiment. I cut off the feed to the speakers. This experiment has a greater effect on its subjects than we imagined. We have to stop it before you suffered any permanent damage. Brian, I need you to come into the lab tonight for observation. Dr. Keats is under observation as well. We will send a car to pick you up after work. I'm sorry.
This is WXSC 86.9. Right now, we have the newest chart topper by Michael White.
Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both. And be one traveler long I stood, and looked down one as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other as just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same, and both that morning equally lay, and leaves no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with this side, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverge in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference.
While initial results were promising, the algorithms over time caused emotional instability in subjects. The potential danger this possesses to society is immeasurable.
I told you, I don't know where he is. He just told me to listen to the radio.
Even the brilliant and sound mind of my colleague, Dr. Keats, was vulnerable.
You don't understand. This was for the world. This was for the world!
Special measures had to be made in order to prevent an outbreak. Any measures necessary to contain this threat should be used in order to preserve our way of life.
This is a request from a listener.
Chances of showers. Tomorrow, we are looking at highs of 80 degrees and lows of 72, with 60% chance of showers.
Okay, folks, we have a listener's submission. This is for Sarah from Brian. I love you with all my heart.